So glad to have you back with us again for our Sunday evening gospel service at the People's Church, Newton Abbey. We just are looking to the Lord tonight, and it's wonderful to be able to talk about Jesus. It's wonderful right now just to put all our focus on Jesus. And I want to read to you something this evening that really declares what Jesus said about himself. Let me read to you from John chapter 10 and verse number 7. Listen to these words of the Lord Jesus. They are eternal. They're full of promise. They're full of living hope. and they're for you and I today. Listen to what the Lord Jesus said. It says, "Then Jesus said to them again, 'Most assuredly, I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. All who ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door,' he says. 'If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and go in and out and find pasture. The thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly.'" May the Lord bless those few verses. Can we just pray for a moment? Let's just take a moment to thank the Lord for his word and to look to him for help. Father, you're in this meeting tonight. It's your day. It's your time. We've come back again to give you our praise, to look to you with all of our hearts. Thank you for this morning and the driving. Thank you for your worship and your word that went out again. Thank you for the people who were coming. Thank you for those who are tuning in tonight online. Lord, will you bless your word right now unto our hearts, and will you glorify your own precious name. Let your way go out tonight. Let your light shine tonight. Let your word have free course tonight, and bless it for Jesus' sake. Amen. Amen. You know, we have read something tonight that really is a title of the Lord Jesus, and it's a title that the Lord gave himself. He said, "I am the door. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture." What a declaration this is. Just full of promise, just full of hope. "I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and go in and out and find pasture." You know, the Lord loves to speak in ways that relate to us. He's not abstract. He's not ambiguous in his promises. And he uses here a common object of a door, something that we all understand, something that we know very well, that we're so familiar with. I got new doors in my house last year. I counted every one of them. I didn't know how as many doors, or that I walked through so many doors every day, until I had to pay for every one of them to get them replaced. There was over a dozen doors, and they're all used for a reason, for a purpose that all of my family are very, very familiar with. And we are very familiar with doors. And there's great doors, ornamental doors on great cathedrals, car doors, fire doors, doors to the kitchen, doors outside, tents have doors, all kinds of doors, on greenhouses even, and every other imaginable kind of door, large doors, small doors, side doors, thin doors, wide doors, on and on and on. And of course, they all serve a purpose. And when the Lord Jesus said here, "I am the door," it was the purpose of the door that he really wanted to get across to us tonight. "I am the door," he said. "By me, if any man enters in, he shall be saved." What about that for a promise? He shall be saved. And it goes on, "and go in and out," he said, "and find pasture. If anyone comes and enters by me, he shall be saved. She shall be saved. They shall be saved and go in and out and find pasture." You know, it's all that this door stands for tonight that we want to highlight to you, and we want to just get across to you. You see, a door is a means of entrance. We know that. We're so aware of that. Doors are a means of entrance. And the Lord Jesus came as the way, the entrance. into all that we need in God and all that God has for us. It comes through Jesus. That's what he meant when he said, I am the door. And here's the fact tonight, to enter a building, and you go into buildings all the time and go into places all the time, but you've got to go right through the entrance. You've got to go right through the door. I was in a museum last year in New York City, in fact, and the Natural History Museum in New York City, and I never saw doors like it. They were massive. They must have been 20 feet high or maybe even more. But that was only the beginning. Going through that door was only the beginning. I had to go right through those doors into the entrance foyer of the National History Museum in New York City, up near Central Park there. But I had to go right through the entrance to come into all of that place had to offer. And here's the truth tonight. You've got to come right through into God. You've got to come right through the Lord Jesus as the door into God. Now, the fact is this. I came near that building. I stood outside for a while and looked around and had a drink of water because it was a hot day and I was outside. But the time came when I had to go right through the door into the building. And maybe that's you tonight. You've come near so often. You've come near the ways of God and the things of God. But there has to be a time when you come right through the entrance into all that God has for you. What about letting that happen tonight? What about letting that take place tonight? You can come near, but you've got to enter in. A door is a means of entrance. There was only one door in Noah's Ark. And Genesis 6 and verse 16 says, you shall make a window for the ark and shall finish it to a cubit from above and set the door, not plural, but singular, only one, set the door, the only door of the ark in its side. There was only one way in to that way of salvation from the flood that was Noah's Ark. Very, very important to understand that. That was for a reason, because there's only one way into God. And by the way, the tabernacle in the wilderness, the place where God said, make me a building, a tent of meeting, and I'll meet with you there, I'll dwell with you there. There was only one door into the tabernacle. Please understand that for a reason. There wasn't a back door or another door or multiple doors, just one door. It was all signifying something. There's only one way into God. And Jesus came in flesh and said these words, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one comes unto the Father except through me. He's the door tonight. He is the only door. The Bible declares again, Acts 4 and 12, nor is there salvation in any other, for there's no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Do you know something? We've been quoting that verse for the last four Sunday nights for good reason, because it's important and it's true. Jesus is the door. Listen to what he said again. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he shall be saved. What a promise that is. If you're looking for God's salvation, you're going to get it when you come to the Lord Jesus. He shall be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. Notice that last bit, find pasture. It speaks of satisfaction. It speaks of feeding. It speaks of fulfillment. And that's what you're going to find in the Lord. Here's the truth tonight. Jesus not only saves, he satisfies. Jesus not only regenerates you and transforms you and changes your life, he fulfills you and he fills you. Oh, it's wonderful. Jesus saves and he satisfies. When the Lord said, I am the door, he means he is in the entrance into all of that. If you haven't come right through yet, what's stopping you? What's stopping you? You're missing out on so much. Don't let another day go by. Don't let another hour go by. Don't let another moment go by. Come right through tonight. Jesus says, I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he shall be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. It's waiting for you. It's all waiting for you. Listen, I've done that over 30, almost 40 years ago. And I'm here to tell you tonight, it was the best thing you ever done. If you're holding back this evening, don't hold back a day longer. Come right through the entrance. Jesus says, I am the door. Come right through into all that God has for you. Doors are a way of entrance. This is to do with the relatedness of God. Jesus spoke in language that people could relate to so that they could understand what he was, what he was offering. Doors were a means of entrance. He says, I am the door. But we also know this, don't we? That doors are a means of separation. Doors are a means of separation too. You know, a door separates us. I'm in a separate office here in our church building, but the door's closed and it separates me from the corridor and many other offices. Doors are a means of separation. And here's the truth tonight. When you come to the Lord Jesus and commit to him and follow him, it separates you from the ways of this world. Now that's a good thing. Let me tell you why that's a good thing. Because the world is destroying itself. Because the world is passing away. And when you come in, I am the door, Jesus says. Not only a way in by entrance, also a way of separation. It separates you from the ways of this world and the things of this world. As Christian believers, we are to turn our backs on the sinful, evil ways of this world and identify ourselves with the people of God. When the Lord Jesus declared himself as the door of the sheepfold, he was implying he would be the great divider. This door divides this office from other offices. And we are separated unto God. And that's a good thing. Because we're following a different drum beat tonight. We're walking a different path tonight. And listen, we're going to a different place tonight. We have a different destination. And Christian, you've got a different destiny. Understand this whole truth of biblical separation, Christian separation. It's not a negative. It's a positive. The world is destroying itself. We can't get caught up in these ways of this world. The world is passing away. The Bible says, but those who do the will of the Lord will abide forever. A door is a way of separation. And that's what will happen to you. That's what will take place to you. Yes, you'll be separate, but that's a good thing from the things and the evil of this world and the sin of this world that can destroy you. And the Lord has to take that from you. And the Lord has to change you. But let him do it, because he has so much positive to bring your way. But not only that, a door is a means of protection. A means of protection. You know, when I was young and growing up, and we were looking at some photographs. Some of my mates have got in touch. And one of my boyhood friends, I just found out this week, one of my boyhood friends, Lofty from the Shankill Road, he was in touch this week. He got saved recently. And he's rejoicing in the Lord. He's cheering. I was on the phone with him. And you could feel the joy. He says, I feel brilliant, John. I feel great. I've got my life sorted out. But we were looking at some photographs this week where we grew up, right on the Peace Line in West Belfast. And, you know, we didn't need entertainment. We had entertainment every night. We didn't need 5.1 Dolby digital sound. We had the echoes of SLRs and machine guns, Thompson machine guns, all the time, echoing. It was just a norm to us. We weren't used to anything else. We got used to that. It's terrible even to think about, but that's the way it was. And there was gun battles, without exaggeration. There was, I know the Troubles can be exaggerated and people can exaggerate, but it was. There was gun battles. Often there were gun battles. But here's the truth. As long as our door was shut, I felt safe. Now, I might have been wrong or I might have been right, but it made me feel safe. The door being shut, I just felt protected. And you know that a door is a means of protection. And you know, we have come to a time in our history where people are frightened to go beyond the door. They just want to keep their doors shut. They just want to get in and shut the door because there's a sense, a psychological sense, a psychological feeling that they're safe as long as the door's shut and locked behind them and they're in their own habitat. The underlying truth that a door is a means of protection. I want to tell you something tonight. When you come into the fullness of Jesus Christ, you're under the canopy of the greatest protector in the universe. I want to just say that to you tonight. When Jesus said, "I am the door," he was saying something here. When you come into me, I'll protect you. When you come into me, you'll have the greatest protection in the world. Close doors against the icy blasts of winter. Have you felt that when it's the sleet and the wind howling outside, the snow beating down, and you come in, there's a great feeling. You just close the door, lock it behind you, and you sigh a sigh of relief. You're in your house now and you're safe and it's warm. You know what Jesus is saying here? I am the door. When you come unto me, you'll have the greatest protection you could ever dream of, and it's eternal, brothers and sisters. And there's so much coming to this world. There's so much coming to our lives. But I want to tell you something. The Lord is our shield tonight. The Lord is our protector. We have got problems coming our way. We have got situations coming our way. But let me remind you of something else. We have the icy blast of death coming our way. And it's coming to us all. But you see, if you're in Jesus Christ tonight, you'll be protected from that even in the end, because he'll go through that with you and bring you out into his everlasting life. When Jesus says, "I am the door," it meant something, and he meant something. A door is a way of shelter. Can I ask you tonight, is he your door? Is he your door? We said at the beginning, you can come near the door. You can come near the door of someone's house. But really, to fellowship with them, you've got to go through the door and work into where they are. You can come to the door of any building or any place, but you've got to come through it and right into all it has to offer. Is it your door tonight? Have you come right through yet? If you haven't, will you do it tonight? Can I leave you with another truth just to end? Because we need to know this as well. A door is a means of exclusion. A door is a means of exclusion. Something happened a lot of years ago. We laugh about it now, but I wasn't laughing at the time. I was cutting our grass one day. And my dear wife, who's absolutely brilliant, who I couldn't ask for a better wife, who I thank God for every day, my brilliant, wonderful, incredible, thoughtful, so many times, but she wasn't thoughtful this night, or this day, Jackie. I was in the back, cutting the back lawn, it was about 6 foot wide or square or something, bit of a yard we had. We were in England at the time, and I was out the back cutting the grass, and she decided to go out. And what she done was, not only did she lock the front door, but she also locked the back door. And I had nothing with me but a lawnmower. Didn't have a phone, didn't have anything. And she took herself off for the afternoon. And it was Saturday afternoon. And it was the football season. And I had plans to watch some football later on in the afternoon. And my dear wife, the Lord bless her, She locked every door in the house, and I was locked out for hours, honestly. And it was near the end of summer. It was October, in fact, and I was given the final cut to the grass. It was freezing, and I was locked out. And here's the sad thing. You ready? Here's the sad thing. I could almost see the TV in the distance from where I was, and the match was starting. And I could smell the food that I was going to cook to watch the match, but I couldn't get in because the door was locked. I couldn't get in because Jackie locked the door. And when she came home, it took that long. When she came home, before she came home, the Lord ministered to me saying, be gracious to her. She forgot. Don't lose your cool. Don't lose your temper. And I've done that, and we laugh about it, but I wasn't laughing then. But I always remember that, because I remember the door was the door of separation. And Jesus said this, I am the door. By me, if anyone enters in, they will be saved and go in and out and find pasture. But can I remind you tonight, in all urgency, in all soberness, that one day that door is going to be shut. That one day that door is going to be closed and never opened again. This is the final door. You will have a final opportunity. And if you don't take it, it will be too late. And it might be tonight for you. And God might be speaking to you tonight. But I want to encourage you, because the door is open tonight. Don't, whatever you do, neglect him. Don't, whatever you do, put him off. Because that door will not be open forever. You don't know if you'll have next week. You don't know if you'll have next opportunity. But you have it tonight. A door is a door that secludes. And can I just leave you with that tonight? The final door, the final opportunity. And it's God speaking to you this evening through what the Lord Jesus said. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, they will be saved and go in and out and find pasture, find so much, find all that they were looking for in life. It's all in what the Lord has for you. But you've got to come across the threshold tonight into the fullness of that. Would you do it this evening? Would you do it with all of your heart? Remember, it's the entrance into so much. It's also the provision the Lord gives. It's through that door. And also the protection that the Lord gives as well is through that door. The separation, you know, you need to cut the sin of this world from you, because it'll destroy you. And we have to highlight these things, because sin is destroying people. It's not a good thing. The gospel is positive. People are frightened to talk about sin, saying, oh, we don't want to put people off. Sin is destroying people. The gospel sets them free. The gospel will separate them. You're not what you used to be when you come to the Lord. He changes you. He changes your desires. We lofty this week was rejoicing. The Lord has done something in him. The Lord's done something in us. And we want to tell it to the world tonight. And it's the same for you. And listen, if you forget everything we ever say, don't forget this. It is no secret what God can do. What he's done for others, he'll do for you. Will you come in tonight? Through this broadcast, will you come into the fullness of God tonight? I want to pray a prayer that can bring you in. I want to pray a prayer that can get you through into this. Because we're going to pray it in the name of Jesus. We're going to come by the way of the cross. We're going to come by the name of the Lord Jesus tonight, who said, I am the door. By me, if anyone enters in, they will be saved. There's the promise for you. And go in and out and find pasture. Find all that you ever dreamed of and all that you ever needed. It's all in him tonight. It's true. We're here to tell you it's true. We're doing this to tell you it's true. Now, will you come with all of your heart? Christian, as you're listening, will you rejoice for what you have? It's happened to you. Oh, bless the Lord for it. We're going to pray. Let's just pray a prayer. And I'll pray a line. And if you're listening tonight and you want to come into all that the Lord has for you, you want to open yourself to him, you want to come across the threshold, just pray these lines and mean it from your heart, because it'll bring you in. Bible says, whoever calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. That's what we're doing right now. Come on, let's pray. Lord, I come to you with all of my heart and just as I am. Will you take me now and bring me in to the fullness of you? I give you my life tonight. I open myself tonight to you. But I come in to the fullness of you. Full forgiveness, a full cleansing, a full change, a full transformation, and a new beginning from this night and forevermore. Will you hear my call on the grounds of your word? Father, save me, because I come through the Lord Jesus, who is the door to you, the door of salvation, and the door of fulfillment. Thank you for hearing me. I trust you with all of my heart from this night and forevermore. Amen. Amen. God bless you. If you prayed that prayer, let us know. Our numbers will be following in just a moment. You can ring us about anything. We want to hear from you. Send in your prayer requests. But if you prayed that prayer tonight, let us know. We want to rejoice with you. We want to help you. We want to pray with you again. But Christian, go on in the Lord. Oh, just go on in the knowledge of what he means to you, what he has for you, what you have now. But listen, what's coming in the future? The Lord is with you. Come back tomorrow night, please, for our call to prayer. It's very, very important, the most important time of the week. And we're going to meet here tomorrow night at 7:30. And we hope to see you there. And remember the drive-in on Wednesday night. Phone Kelly from tomorrow between 10 and 1. Book your place. More and more people are coming. But the Lord bless you. Come on. Rejoice in the Lord always. And let's rejoice tonight. We're loved and forgiven. And we have done the right thing. Coming into the fullness of the Lord through Jesus Christ the door. Hallelujah. What a wonderful reality. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless you now.